Alrighty, so today we are planning on talking about, we are starting a new chapter, chapter 10, and this chapter deals with quadratic equations and quadratic functions. Today we're going to start with talking about quadratic equations, something very basic in the quadratic equation sense, but it can be complex at times. First off, we're gonna show you the most basic quadratic function, which is y equals x squared. And being able to graph this at this time, you can make a table showing the giving it x values, substituting in that x, and getting the y values, and then plugging them into our graph. So for this example, I'm going to give you points, let's say negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. Now, if I were to plug these x values into this equation, we will get y values to satisfy those x values. So if I were to substitute negative 2 into the y equals x squared equation, I would get 4 for my y. Also, if I were to substitute in negative 1, I would get 1. 0, I would have 0. 1, I would get 1. And 2, I would get 4. So if you're having trouble figuring out how I got those answers, I'll just use the negative 2 for example. So say I have y equals, and I'm plugging in my negative 2 in for x. And readiness is just like saying negative 2 times negative 2. And since taking a negative, multiplying it by another negative, whatever we get as our result will be positive. So that's where we get the 4. Now, in this graph shown here, let's remove some of the numbers. So let's say that this is 2, that's 4, this is negative 2. That's negative 4. And let's remove all the zeros from this particular graph. So then it's just 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So now we're just plugging in the points. So negative 2 and 4, which would be right about here. Negative 1 and 1, which would be somewhere, I would say, right about there. 0 and 0, that's right at the origin. 1 and 1, right about here. And 2 and 4. Now, if we were to connect these points all together, we get a shape that is called a parabola. Now, these are one of the conic sections, and you'll learn about that later on. Two distinct characteristics for a parabola, one of which is the axis of symmetry, which is the line that passes through the vertex and cuts the parabola into two equal parts. As you can see, where the red line is in this graph is the axis of symmetry, and for the parent quadratic function, it's the y-axis. Now, the other characteristic is the vertex. The vertex is the point on the parabola that intersects the axis of symmetry. And for this case, it is at 0 comma 0. So let's go to some examples. This example, they want us to graph the equation y equals ax squared plus c and compare it with y equals x squared, the graph that we just graphed up top. So I'm going to do the exact same things that I did for the parent graph function. I'm going to make up y and x value, make y and x table, and I'm going to make up x values. So negative, well, let's go negative 2. How about that? And then negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. Usually those five numbers can give you a good idea of what kind of graph we're going to come up with. So if I were to take negative 2 and plug it into this equation, it would look like this. So it'd be like y equals 1/2 over negative 2 squared. So we remember from up top, negative 2 squared equals 4, and 4 times 1/2 will give you 2. Negative 1 squared will give you 1, and times that by 1/2 will give you 1/2. Zero, multiply, or substitute 0 into x. 1/2 times 0 is 0. 1/2 times 1 is 1/2. And 2 squared is 4. 4 times 1/2 give you 2. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the function y equals x squared that we did up top, which if you did 0, 0, so we got what, 1, and let me look, let me take a look, see what was the, so it's 1 and 1, 2 and 4, okay, so it's 1 and 1, and then 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, same thing here, 4, and the red, this red one here is considered our y equals x squared. Okay, so now let's take a look, see at our new equation, y equals 1/2 x squared. And so I got negative 2 and 2. I got negative 1 and 1/2. Still at 0 comma 0. 1, 1/2, and 2 comma 2. And so that's what our graph sort of looks like. I apologize for my amazing artwork. And they want us to compare these two graphs. Now, both of these graphs are positioned in what is called a positive, what's the correct term for it? Well, if A, for instance, is positive, it'll point up like this. If it was negative, it would come down something like this. So they're both positive. They're both vertexes are at 0 comma 0, and the only difference is the points. And for this case, it looks like y equals 1 half x squared appears larger or fatter than y equals x squared, and the correct term for that is that the equation is at a vertical shrink. So what that means is that as x is getting larger, it isn't traveling as fast in the y direction as it is our apparent equation y equals x squared. Okay, let's try another. So, same thing, we have y equals 3x squared, and we're going to do the same exact things as we did from the previous equation. I'm going to use the same x values, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. And this case, let's see here. We got negative 2 squared gives us 4. 4 times 3 is 12. Negative 1. Negative 1 squared is 1. 1 times 3 is 3. So 0 squared is 0. 0 times 3 is still 0. We got 1. 1 squared is 1. So we got 3. And 2 squared is 4. And 4 times 3 is 12. Okay, so let's see what we have here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we got 10. It's a 10 by 10 graph, so let's look here. I'm going to just pretend that negative 2 to 12 is somewhere up here. And so let's make my 2 and 12 up here. And so we'll have negative 1 and 3. Go inside 0 comma 0. And also 1 and 3. So that is our graph of y equals 3x squared. And if we were to compare that to our original graph, something kind of like this. This is our original graph, the y equals x squared. And as you look, it still has the same vertex, it's still going in a positive direction. And the difference is our y equals 3x squared is skinnier than our original equation. And usually that means that it's traveling faster as x gets larger, and what is called a technical term is called a vertical stretch. Okay, let's try another. This one here, we've introduced an addition sign to our equation, so but we still use the same tactics by making the table. So we have negative 2 squared will give us 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. Negative 1 squared is 1. 1 plus 4 is 5. 0 squared is 0, 0 plus 4 is 4. And 1 squared is 1, that's plus 4 is 5, and 2 squared is 4, 4 plus 4 is 8. So let's plug in these terms, so negative 2s and negative 8, negative 2 and 8, so we got 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0 and 4, 0 and 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are the points on our parabola. And again, we're going to compare it to our original equation, y equals x squared. So here, 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 here. Now, if you remember, this is our equation y equals x squared. You see that how we have the same x squared by itself? That shows that they have the same either vertical stretch or vertical shrink in both equations. But the only difference is our example has a plus 4 in it. And what all that changed was the location of the vertex of that particular equation. This vertex is now at 0 comma 4, where original equation was at 0 comma 0. Okay, so now this last one, they want us to compare y equals negative x squared with our y equals x squared. And I'm not going to make a table for this one. Well, I guess I can. Let's make a table. Okay. So negative 2 squared is 4. But we have to add the negative after that, so it's negative 4. Negative 1 squared is 1. Gotta add the negative, so that's negative 1. 0 times 0 is 0. 1 squared is 1, but you have to add the negative. And 2 squared is 4, but then you have to add the negative. So it looks kinda like, so I got negative 2, negative 4. Now, as you can see, it looks very similar because it has the same stretcher shrink as our original equation, but it is shifted in the negative direction. So that's how we can compare those graphs with our original equation. Another thing they're going to ask is graph the equation with a transformation. Now, transformation can be one of two things. One, they want you to compare it to the y equals x squared, which for the most part is what is going to be on your homework. Or they will want you to graph, or they want you to compare it to two separate equations that are not related with y equals x squared. So, for this case, let's again, just like from the other ones, make a table. Let me drop it down a little bit here so we can see the whole graph. And give me a y, give me an x. And let's just use the same ones we've been using, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. So, if I were to take negative 1 Or I'm sorry, negative 2 and square, that gives me 4. 4 times 4 times 1 quarter is 1. 1 minus 3 is negative 2. 1 minus, oh, I'm sorry, negative 1 squared is 1. 1 times 1 fourth is 1 fourth. Then 1 fourth minus 3 would be negative. Would be what, negative 2.75? If x is 0, 0 times a quarter is 0, and that leaves us just left with the negative 3. With 1, we still get a negative 2.75. And 2, 4, that's giving us negative 2. So I'm going to plug these points in. Negative 2, 2. Negative 1, 2.75, 0. Let me erase this. I was given it in the positive sense. It should have been negative. My bad. Okay, let's try this again. So negative 2 comma negative 2. That's probably better. Negative 1, 2.75, 0 comma 3. And that's so let's just, for instance, let's compare it to y equals x squared. So here we have a vertex that's at 0 comma 3, which is shifted 3 units down from our parent equation, and it's still po in a positive direction, and it is currently at a vertical shrink in our the way it's positioned on the graph. Let's do here. I think this is the last graph of the examples. So bear with me. Still gonna make our table. Use our same numbers we had before. And negative 2 squared is 4. 4 times 3 is 12, but it's a negative, so that gives us a negative 12. Negative 12 plus 4 will give us a negative 12 plus 8, I'm sorry, will give us a negative 4. 1 squared is 1, a negative 1 squared is 1, times that by negative 3 is negative 3, so that's what? That would be what, 5? Negative 0, so that's what, 8? 1. Our graph kind of looks something like this. So, with comparison to our original parent equation, it is going in a negative direction, and the vertex is at 0, 8, and because it's a non-fraction number in A, we are currently at a vertical stretch with comparison to our y equals x squared. So last thing, when it comes to transformations with y equals x squared, if we look at y equals ax squared, where a is greater than 0. So let's just, for all three graphs, I'm just going to make a rough sketch of what would y equals x squared would look like. Something like this, something like this, something like that. So all those graphs in red are what y equals x squared would look like. Represent as, and if I were to look at the one on the very left, if I have y equals ax squared where a is greater than 0, it could either be have a vertical shrink, which it looks something kind of like this, and usually what that means is there is a fraction attached to a, like 1/2 or 1/4 or 1/3, or we could have ourselves a vertical stretch which looks smaller than our original y equals x squared, and usually that'll have a whole number attached to it, but usually a, like a 3 or a 5 or a 6, it would still have a vertical stretch, as long as, if it's a fraction, as long as that fraction is greater than 1. Now, when we look at y equals ax squared, where a is less than 0, which means that a is a negative number, and so, just like our graph to our left, it can either have a vertical shrink, or a vertical stretch, or it could look just like y equals x squared, but it have a negative attached to it. And those are the different transformations when y equals ax squared when it's a negative number. Now, looking at y equals x squared plus c, what c represents is the location of our parabola, where the vertex is. So, in these other equations, like for this one here, basically we're writing it as y equals x squared plus 0, which means that the vertex is at 0 comma 0. So, and here we have x squared, so it has the same shrink to stretch value. But all it is we're just moving it up a value of c, whatever that may be. Or it also means that it could go c in a negative direction, depending on the value of c that is given. Well, this is audio lesson, this is video lesson 10.1. I hope this helped. And I'll see you next time.